Arthral Studio.
Today is the day 2 of our Pichhwai workshop, and today we are going to create the lotus. Lotus is a flower which is very common in Pichhwai art, and we also call it Kamal Talai, which is a talab or a pond of full of the lotus. So this is very commonly seen in Pichhwai art, and it gives a very beautiful and colorful setting for the picture. Here I am making few of the flowers in different ways, different movement you will see. Not all of them are the same way. There is a symmetry in the center one. It's a petal, and how it is blooming. It is blooming in different sizes, because if it is a talai or the talab, we will see that different sizes of flowers will be blooming in one pond. Few are the buds, and these are relatively very simple to draw. If you are not very comfortable doing it directly with the brush, which is not actually the main way of doing it, for the main picture we do it with pencil. So just give a rough sketch, and later we will be doing the coloring. So when we do the pond or any water body, we see that there are few elements that come along beautifully, and they give a very beautiful setting to the whole picture. So it looks very wholesome. So this is a flower that is dropped down different ways, and if in case you see the stem, you'll have to erase it, because you need to see what is in the background and what is in the foreground. Different angles of the leaf, few half bloomed flowers, full bloomed flowers, different angles of the leaves, and long stems, few buds. And this is how how we can assemble all of them to your own desire. There is no rule how to spread the Kamal Talai. We see it as individual artwork also. We see it as a part of big paintings also. But this lotus and the shading of the lotus, even if we are not doing the Kamal Talai, we are doing Shrinathji or any gods or goddesses along with it. Mainly we do Krishna, and we see that the lotus garland is around his neck, or he is holding lotus flowers. So with the practice of this drawing and the coloring that we will do today, you will get the idea of how we work on this. Now few fishes to go along the pond. Those are not very detailed, very delicate and very curvy. The curve shows the movement very well. We are making it for the birds here, close to it. That's the main reason the birds are there. When we do the Kamal Talai, we do not leave a lot of space. See to it that most of the place is filled up and comfortably, so no, not much overlapping, not much chaos. So comfortably, what is fitting in, we can do that. So this is a base. I'm doing it on an A3 size, but I'm doing it at only the bottom of the page. In different length and in different angles. So there is, once you get the idea of how to do the petals, you will get it into a little motion, and with the wind, with the bend of the heaviness of the flower, a small bend in this will give a beautiful look. So there are different kinds of flowers here, I mean like different kinds of lotuses. What I am taking here is the poster colors and few brushes which have very fine tip. For this, I do not use the cotton cloth. I use tissue paper to wipe my brushes because these are very delicate and I don't want to spoil the tip of it. So I advise you take the tissue paper. It's white poster color and red. Take very little red and mix with white. You will get a very light base of pink. Now when you are doing the flower, I slowed down to show it clearly. When you do a flower, your strokes will go from top to bottom and from bottom to up. So all the strokes will go in the motion of the growth of the flower and not sideways. Just doing a little bit of red on the top and wiping the brush is very important because you do not want a very wet brush. Now creating line by line, pulling that red inside. This will give you a very soft grade in the color and you will see that we will be creating layers on the flower. We can also go halfway pink and halfway red and blend it with a dry brush or a soft brush. That is okay. But when you create these fine lines, you actually feel the texture of the flower. When you hold a lotus flower, you'll see that petals have the veins in it and that beauty comes when you do it in this manner. So first you'll see that the layers, very light ones, then light, a little darker pink, and then later on we take the grades of the color which are a little darker and then do the same process. Now once the thing is dried, make your thin lines on it, on the sides of the line. So your pencil line should not be visible. So you can go ahead with a little bit of darker shade in red and do the same line. For this, working with colorful pens is not recommended. So if you want to shade your flower, it's better if you shade it with brush. Now here I'm giving a white base and with a pink shade I'm just giving the strokes. When you give the strokes, you have to be very careful that they have to be a stroke and not a flat line. What is the difference between the stroke and the line is, with the stroke you start with the solid and then when we go forward, it goes thinner and it frays, it gets dim and blends. We will repeat with the darker shades. Now what color I'm using is a very diluted form. It's not a thick form, so it's diluted. Even if I'm using white, I'm mixing it with water to give it a very lighter wash because I will be doing a lot of layering on it. The shades will come gradually with lightest color first and then going towards the dark color. Use a very thin brush. Here, when I zoom, you can easily see the lines that are there in different values. So even the values are seen and the softness of the flower can be seen nicely. So once the color dries, you get the real view of it, because otherwise the water is the light's getting reflected with the water. So showing you the consistency of the color that I'm taking, I'm mixing white and water to make it very fluid. So it is like a wash, the color of the wash. Consistency may be a milk-like consistency, not really water consistency. And while the base is wet, put the outlines and then pull it with the brush. If your brush has too much of a concentrated shade, then you need to wipe it with your tissue so that the color gets less. So it is only the damp brush that is pulling the shade in. So lotus, it looks really beautiful, as generally when we see the pictures, either it is scattered everywhere around the background or it is served as the base of the big paintings where we see a lot of perspective. With perspective, I mean that the background has lot of elements like the plants, the trees, the hills, clouds, everything, and then the scenery gives a view where a talab is there or talai is there filled with lotuses. Now there is one very curious thing about that it is in Rajasthan. This art form is very famous in Rajasthan, but at that place we do not have lot of ponds, not many ponds, because that's a very dry place. Then why is this feature mostly seen in that picture? Now, the reason behind is that the idol of Shrinathji was found in Rajasthan, and these talabs were very common in Mathura and Vrindavan, that area, and that's where he spent his childhood. So Krishna as a child, or Krishna as a young boy, used to spend a lot of time in the around the pond, and just depicting the feature of that times, of those times, of his manners, what he used to have. He used to enjoy a lot around with his cows, with gopis, Radha, dancing. All those things happen in the fields and close to the pond. The pond was very big feature, because when of course when he had so many cows along with him, he has to be close to the water source. So maybe that is a connect that this is there. But why is it that in Nathdwara we see that Pichhwai is very famous there, where ponds are not there, but still we see? So it was that the idol was found in that area, in that place, and then the temple was built. That once the temple was built, still the imagery of the place where he used to belong is done in that Pichhwai. Now coming to the lotus leaf. Now here all the strokes will just give it a wash, a green wash. The center stays dark and the outside stays highlighted. We will go in a manner where all the spokes, kind of all the strokes, are going from the center towards the outside, just like a pinwheel. Now creating these shades, what shades did I take is just the green. For the darker shades in green, which is more brownish, I have mixed a little bit of red in the green and we get brown. And again, fine strokes. The stem, we will do one side green and one side darker and the lighter. And that is enough. We don't need to blend too much. Now, this is the side view of the lotus leaf. The stem, all the lines will be dark and the leaf blade will be lighter. All the veins will be darker and all the strokes are again moving from top to bottom. Or outside, from outside to inside, to the center of the petal. The leaf. Now this darker tone is achieved by mixing a little bit black in the green to give it a darker tone. So just coloring the half with the darker color and thereafter with the lighter color, giving a gentle blend in the middle, gives you a decent. Now we'll be doing the detail with the highlights of white. Again, the strokes are very important. Try to be as uniform as possible. While it's drying, we'll go on to the bud. Now here I've applied a little darker tone, just because the buds are more compressed and compact, so the shade is a little darker that I chose. And then the stem again, all the stems that we do are in double tone, so one side it is lighter and the other side it's darker. Now when I I just maintain the tip of my brush, I use the back of my hand because that is very, the skin is softer and then it doesn't spoil the tip of your brush. Be it in the plate, sometimes your color dries and then with this very delicate brush, even if it is not spoiled, it will eventually spoil because with the rubbing on the dry color. So here, if you have not subscribed here and you're liking the channel, you're liking the videos that we do, please share a like with me and your comments as how you liked it. Most of the videos are in live sessions, few might be recorded and shared. Here, after doing the black outline, I'm giving some yellow dots. They look really bright and this looks quite complete. So this is the way we are done with the petals of the lotus, the buds, the few views of the leaves and how to do the kamal talai. Thanks for watching. I will see you soon in my next live session.